Nicolas Cage is one of the most colorful actors in Hollywood, but Nick's flair for the dramatic goes well beyond acting. Welcome to New Orleans. Biography presents Nicolas Cage.
New Orleans is a very important place in my life, and I've been going there for decades. When I'm in New Orleans, I feel both blessed and cursed.
Nick first went down to the Big Easy to film 1990's Wild at Heart. He fell in love with the city and would go on to make 12 more movies in and around New Orleans. Then, in 2007, he decided to put down some roots there. But in true Nicolas Cage fashion, he didn't just buy any house. He bought one of the most notorious houses in New Orleans, La Lurie Mansion, which was once owned by serial killer Madame Delphine La Lurie. Nick no longer owns that house, but he still owns property in the city. That's the pyramid-shaped tomb in the famous St. Louis Cemetery, number one. Cage will have a very interesting neighbor in this cemetery. Voodoo queen Marie Laveau is also buried there. Nick's fascination with the spooky side of New Orleans and the discovery of a 19th century photograph have led to an internet conspiracy that he's actually a vampire.
I have been told about that, yeah. And I have gotten out of bed in the morning and looked in the mirror just to make sure I was still there, and I was. So that would probably end those rumors. Because I'm told that vampires don't have reflections. Why don't we just keep it a mystery? It might be a lot more fun for everybody if I just say it's possible.
Vampire or not, Nicolas Cage will always keep things interesting, on screen and off.